Pase TV show.
Sak
Pase TV. Sak Pase TV show avec Guylene Berry.
Sak Pase. Sak Pase TV. Sak Pase. Sak Pase TV.
C'est Sak Pase TV show avec Guylene Berry. Et je dis à nous tous qui branchés, nous gagnons occasion pour nous faire causer ensemble avec magistrat ville de Miramar, magistrat Wayne Messam. So pour nous tous qui branchés, je dis qui a suivi émission ça sur channel côté que nous suivons lien. Songez, font famille ou bien ami branché pour capable capter qui ça cap passer dans communauté. Alors, nous connaissons que ville Miramar sont une ville qui a bougé, qui a en pile activité qui a fait là dans tout temps parce que magistrat gagnait en pile activité que toujours porter dans ville là. So n'a suivre Sak Pase TV show côté que nous capable pour plus d'informations sur sakpasemedia.com. Sak Pase TV show, your voice, your vision, your story. Et pour nous tous qui branchés, qui a suivi l'émission Sak Pase TV show, comme moi été annoncé tout à l'heure, nous gagnons ensemble avec nous magistrat Wayne Messam, qui pral font causer ensemble avec nous, non seulement de accomplissement ni, qui ça que le fait, qui ça te qu'on fait avant que il était ville magistrat ville Miramar, et qui ça que la fait journée jeudi, et qui plan que le gagne dans le futur. Et monsieur que nous tous qui branchés, nous allons apprendre yon bagage de plus de magistrat Wayne Messam. Good afternoon, Mr. Mayor. Bonsoir.
Bonsoir. How are you?
I'm doing great, thank you. You know what? A lot of people are fascinating. Wow, this is a great city. A lot of things are happening in the city of Miramar. And I also wonder where you came from. Who are you? What are you doing? And what will you be doing? So for those of us that are watching, that are part of this conversation, we'd like to get to know you more.
Okay.
So who are you?
Well, as you know, as you stated before, I'm the mayor of the city of Miramar. I am a first generation American. I am of Caribbean descent. My family is from Jamaica. I was born here in South Florida, like many Haitian Americans that were born here, and grew up in South Florida. I was educated at Florida State University. I was an American football player. I played at Florida State University and the National Football League. But now in my private life, I own a construction management company, as well as serve 134,000 residents as their mayor. So I am married. Angela and I have just celebrated our 19th anniversary this past Monday on December 12th. And we have three children, Wayne, Kayla, and Kyla, who are twins.
Oh, okay. So 19 years of marriage, twins, two girls. I don't know. And he's the mayor also of the city of Miramar. So before that, you're a football player. So growing up, coming from a family from the Caribbean, from Jamaica, did you think about one day you're going to be in politics?
Oh, no. That was something. I grew up in a very small rural community. So my exposure to a city like Miramar was the last thing on my mind. It wasn't until after I stopped playing football and my wife and I were looking to settle in South Florida, and we chose Miramar because of its location. It was right between Miami and Dade County, Miami-Dade and Broward counties.
Yeah.
So the location was great. We had great schools for our young children at the time, and it was just a perfect place for us to settle.
Interesting. So you've been living in Miramar for how long?
For 17 years.
Oh, wow. 17 years. Yes. And at the time, Miramar was not the way we see it right now.
Oh, no. Miramar at that time probably had a population of about maybe 70,000 residents. And throughout that time, the city has exploded. At one time, the Miramar was one of the fastest growing cities in the country.
Oh.
We still have some growth. We're almost built out. But we are now the 13th largest city in the state of Florida and the fourth largest city in Broward County. So we're a major city in the state of Florida, and we are just so blessed to have a very progressive young city that is so diverse with people from all walks of life right here in Miramar.
That's interesting. So I know that you always have programs for residents. We're going to talk about what are the residents benefiting for living in the city of Miramar. And then we're also going to talk about the businesses, how they can benefit for being part of Miramar. So the residents that live here, or people that are looking to relocate, why should they move to Miramar?
Well, depending on what you're looking for specifically, Miramar has something for you. For example, Miramar, the average age in Miramar is 33 years old. So what that means is we have a lot of young families. And Miramar is a wonderful city for young families because we have a very safe community, we have excellent schools, and we have wonderful parks. We have over 40 parks in the city of Miramar, and it's very active, and it's actually our most used asset in the city of Florida because the kids are they're playing soccer, football, basketball, baseball, you name it, they're very active, and we have programs there. We have a great relationship with our school district, which Broward County Schools is one of the largest school districts in the country, so it has a lot of resources for our community. If you are an immigrant family or a multicultural family, you won't feel out of place because chances are there is a neighborhood or an association, or you'll find folks who look like you, speak like you, and like the same foods that you like. So there's a place for everyone. You just feel at home because it's a very diverse community. So if you're a senior and you are living out the rest of your years, your better years, we have two active senior citizens programs here. We call them active Americans or older Americans, and they are great. They go on field trips, shopping, they play dominoes, arts and crafts, and things that they like to do with one another. So we try to be supportive and inclusive of all of our residents that are here.
So that is interesting. You have an age group of 33 years old, part of Miramar, so that means millennials?
What we have quite a few millennials. In fact, we have an opportunity to increase those activities for the young professional. They may not have children or are just looking for career options. And we're actually working on some programs to prepare those young, active millennials who are looking or embarking upon their professional life, to prepare them, because we have so many wonderful companies here in the city of Miramar. We want to make sure they have every opportunity to be able to work for some wonderful companies that are here in our city.
Okay, so you definitely have a place for young people, for people like me, and also people that are having children or looking to have children, and also a place for the seniors. So pour nous même qui branché là, nous attendons qui sa magistrat Wayne Messam se partager ensemble avec nous de qui sa ville Miramar a porté pour monde qui voulait résident ville Miramar. Là que nous retournons, nous allons parler de opportunité pour business, parce que nous toutes qui branché là, nous connaît que economic development très important pour développement yon ville. Le Notounek, on a discuté de ça tout à l'heure dans ce Sak Pase TV show. Your voice, your vision, your story.
I felt like I had no self-esteem. I remember one morning I went to the clinic and I was feeling really depressed.
It's normal to experience the baby blues after delivery for up to 2 weeks. If those feelings continue, it is important to seek help in dealing with postpartum depression.
Say that I was very happy to be a part of the program because I was referred to a therapist, and I got counseling. I was able to interact with other mothers that was going through similar situations, that was, you know, depressed, that was stressed. If they're going through stress, if they're going through depression, as far as getting, you know, having a therapist working with them, not being able to get to their baby's appointment, not being able to provide for their children, because in that sense too, the program has helped me with, you know, diapers, has helped me with a lot of different stuff. So I really think that it's a very good program. If you're feeling lonely, if you're feeling stressed, if you're feeling depressed, call the number on the screen. Don't be afraid. Don't be ashamed. Help is just a call away.
C'est TV Show et merci de ce que nous branchons émission ça. Et pendant que nous branchons, m'a rappelé nous que tous les jours nous capable suivre Cause Femme sur 1580 AM dans sud Floride là et dans Orlando Radio Panique sur 99.9 FM. Nous avons quelques petites annonces pour nous toujours et songez si nous t'aimer faire réclame ensemble avec nous, nous t'aimer advertise if you'd like to advertise your business on Sak Pase Media, you can go ahead and call us at 321-710-9010. Pour nous faire réclame ensemble avec nous avec Sak Pase Media, nous pouvez contacter nous dans 321-710-9010 ou bien visiter nous sur sakpasemedia.com. Et comme nous connaissons déjà, je dis à l'invité du jour, c'est M. Wayne Messam de Ville Miramar, qui est magistrat Ville Sahar. Nous sommes parlé de résidents, et pour qui raison que nous avons adoré penser à Move ou bien pour habiter dans Ville Miramar. Mais Kounier, nous allons parler de l'aspect business. Nan. Parce que nous connaissons l'économique développement dans toute ville, c'est un moyen pour capable aider non seulement ville, nan, mais monde qui t'a aimé aider business yo grandi. So, Mr. Mayor, Mr. A little bit about economic development in this great city of Miramar.
Well, Miramar is really on fire. For 2 years in a row, Miramar has ranked as one of the fastest growing economies in the country for cities between 100,000 to 300,000 residents, and we're very proud. Most of those companies have brought in on an average over 100 jobs with the average salary, meaning salaries of over $60,000 for each position. So these are great and good paying jobs to be able to fuel these companies, as well as being able to have them as our residents if they choose to live here in the city of Miramar. Miramar has more Fortune 500 companies than any city in South Florida.
Interesting, such as?
Well, we have companies like Kellstrom Defense, AMD Medical, we have Humana, Carnival, Royal Caribbean, Comcast, American Express. Wow. Many of them have their Latin American headquarters right here in the city of Miramar. So, but we also have a vibrant small business community as well in mid-sized companies. So our charge is to ensure that there's natural synergies among those companies. So if our larger companies are using companies out of the country or out of state, we want to introduce them to some of the Miramar businesses who can provide the same service, if not better, for them and being right here in the city of Miramar. So those are some of the things that we're looking to do and to foster. We just completed our economic development study where we've interviewed businesses, large, medium, and small, and mom and pop, to see how the city can better service them. So we have that information, we've compiled it, and we're taking, we're analyzing that information to see what type of programs and resources we can make available for the business community.
Isn't that wonderful? So not only you are one of the cities that have the most 500 Fortune magazine, Fortune
500.
businesses in the city of Miramar, but they also have programs for people that are starting businesses and also people that are looking into having their businesses in the city of Miramar. So those programs you're talking about are what kind of incentives?
Well, first of all, we actually last week, the city of Miramar conducted a small business outreach event where we brought in local agencies on providing resources for small businesses to get them acclimated, how to start their business, or if they want to do business with the city of Miramar, with Broward County. We provided connections with CareerSource, which is a workforce agency that provides grants and training and technical training for prospective employees as well as your current employees. The city of Miramar has a grant program where we make available $10,000 for qualified businesses to create or to retain a job. We have those type of incentives. If you are a property owner, and let's say if you're in our historic side of town, and you want your property may be a bit dated, and you want to renovate and modernize your exterior facade, we have CDBG funds, which is a federal grant that allows property owners to use those dollars to fix up their properties, weatherize the property, put in new storefronts, and make it more modern so that they can attract more tenants in their property.
That's interesting. Yes. $10,000. Gen 10 000 dollars que offri comme incentive pour nous-mêmes qui t'a remé joindre plus information t'as le conseil magistrat Wayne Messam Galbano plus information sur tout programme ça que nous capable bénéficier de dans ville de Miramar n'a pas pause et n'a tourné t'as le conseil sur émission panoua ça passe TV show avec Guylene B.
Ou gen cancer trois mots ou pas table jamais remet tendez mais juste parce que diagnostic cancer capable un choc pour système ou pas veut dire chirurgie cancer c'est même bagaille là li rele edge radio surgery li puissant li efficace et li pas senti tant que c'est chirurgie ou fait du tout yo pas coupé ou et ou pas arrêté l'hôpital gen seulement yon seul grand hôpital dans Miami qui offre opération edge surgery ça rele North Shore Medical Centers Cancer Center dans 305-835-6173 pour kawe si radio surgery a bon pour vous.
Come to discover a place where magic and tradition are a part of the fabric of everyday life. Experience the flavors of a unique cuisine. Let yourself be dazzled by its colors. And lose yourself in its rhythms. Come to Haiti. Discover the soul of the Caribbean.
Vive l'expérience!
Sur website yo, al visite yo sur www.boward.org/icondev, boward.org/icondev. Ou bientôt nous kabrele yo nan 954-327-6400, 954-327-6400. Et genye yo dan krele Jasmine Jones ki a bien content adresse question nou yo en créole. So pour nous même qui a cherché opportunité pour business, m'a fait nous connaître que al visiter website boward.org/icondev, c'est Office of Economic and Small Business Development of Broward County que nous fait que s'entendre magistrat Will Messam mentionné que il travaille de concert ensemble avec yo. Et puis et pour nous même qui gagne petit monde et qui t'a remet jouer plus opportunité pour after school care ou bien pour programme pour toute famille hein, m'a fait nous connaître que Children's Services Council of Broward County gagne en pile information sur website YouTube allez sur csc.org csc.broward.org csc.broward.org ou bien relé au 211-211. Pour nous qui suivre là si nous t'a remet faire réclame ensemble avec nous songez contactez-nous dans 321-710-90-10 ou bien visitez-nous sur sakpasemedia.com et songez brancher Cause Femme tous les jours sur 1580 AM ou sakpasemedia.com qui qu'on listen live pour nous capables suivre Cause Femme tous les jours à partir de 3h. Et si n'a pas gardé émission ça, si nous remettons pour famille bons amis captez-nous sou station kote ke nou ye nan le ke nan gade la. Et jodi an, comme était annoncé déjà, magistrat Guylene Messam li invite nou tout pou nou kapab konnen ki sa kap pase nan ville de Miramar. Si nou invite nan si nou habite nan ville Miramar, nou kapab toujours contacter ville la et li pral partager ensemble avec nous quelques informations pour nous capable connait qui département qui capable utile nous selon côté que nous rete dans ville Miramar. So, magistrat Guylene Messam, meilleur Messam, nous connait que nous même qui branché là, il est très important pour nous connait qui ça va passer dans ville nous. Et c'est une bagarre que toujours dit que nous c'est habitant ville là ou bien que nous c'est business owner dans ville là, parce que il est très important pour nous connait qui côté pour nous contacter là que nous avons besoin. So some of my the viewers, they would like to know some information about how to contact the city, whether it's for the residents or for business. So what are some of the resources you'd like to share with us today?
Well, the main number here at the city of Miramar that can direct you to get information regardless of what your need is 954-602-HELP, and let the operator know exactly what you are in need of, and they will be able to direct you to the right department. That's 954-602-HELP.
Notre numéro, c'est 954-602-HELP, H-E-L-P. Ou bien, nous capables et songer le nom relé, demander qui côté que nous voulons pour nous contacter. Ça veut dire, l'opérateur ou bien l'opératrice répond, dit qui ça exactement que nous besoin. C'est 954-602-HELP. 602-HELP, H-E-L-P.
And I would also encourage you, the viewing audience, to visit our brand new, very robust website, which is www.miramarfl.gov. So www.miramarfl.gov.
That's easy. No comment ça. C'est miramar.fl.gov.
Miramarfl.gov.
Oh, there's no dot.
No.
After Miramar.
Miramarfl.gov.
Okay. Miramarfl.gov.
Yes.
G-O-V. So, pour nous tous qui branchés, songez, nous gagnons un numéro de téléphone qui c'est 954-602-HELP, H-E-L-P, ou bien nous pouvons aller sur le website Miramar, là, sur miramarfl.gov. And, you know, I like to ask people, so you told me about what you've done before becoming a mayor, what you're doing as a mayor, and what are your future plans?
Well, you know, I'm just 2 years in my first term as mayor, so I have a lot of work to do here in the city of Miramar, and I look forward to serving for some time here in Miramar to get some important projects done. We're building a brand new amphitheater in our regional park. We are modernizing and renovating our historic side of town, putting in new infrastructure and paving our roads way in our east and historic side of town. And I want to see those projects get completed. As a young elected official, I'm very active on the national and state level. So there are many opportunities out. I can't rule out any future opportunities, but I do know that they are there. But I want to do a really good job here in Miramar. And then when my time is up here in Miramar, then I'll decide which option I can best serve, if I decide to continue to serve. So, but I do would like to see, I see our country as we are becoming more diverse, and we are right now, you look at the national news in the U.S., you see the convergence of the various cultures, and this state and this country does need leadership to be able to bring our country together, someone who will be able to ensure that the ideals of our Constitution are met. So that no matter who you are, no matter where you're from, whether you're born here in the United States or if you're an immigrant and become a naturalized citizen, that you have every opportunity to be successful and be able to have to achieve the American dream, and that's what everyone has the right to do. And if the citizens would have me to serve in a capacity to help our fellow Americans and Floridians to do that, and we will see where that future may lead.
Okay, we'll see where that future may lead. N'ap gade et pour nous voir qui côté que et magistrat Guylene Messam pour aller dans le futur, mais il fait nous connaître que lui-même li là pour capable servir communauté hein, il est seulement servi 2 ans déjà. So la poursuivre pour voir qui Jean bagaille a développé. Dans suite ça passe TV show. Il a presque arrivé dans tout état.
Sak Pase TV show, hosted by Miss Berry. Sak Pase TV show motivates, entertains, and informs. Your support is very much appreciated. We're looking forward for your sponsorship, contribution, and support. Watch us on this channel or on demand at sakpasetv.com. For more information, contact us at sakpasemedia.com.
Mayor Messam, one of my issues are affordable housing. Mm-hmm. I know that you've spoken about a lot of different stuff, but it is important that our viewers understand what is affordable housing and what is your city doing for affordable housing.
Well, for any city to be a full service city to be successful, it's incumbent upon the city to provide access to affordable housing. And Miramar is actually in the process of trying to make access to affordable housing better in the city of Miramar. The city of Miramar, we don't have a housing authority where we provide subsidized housing for those who may be of low income. And because our city is very progressive, it's a very desirable city, and the economics of that, there's a very high demand for property values. So sellers market in Miramar, because many people want to live here in the city. And unfortunately, what that does is it increases the property values. So affordable housing is a challenge here in the city of Miramar. However, one of the things that I'm looking forward to is we have some undeveloped tracts of land that is slated to have multifamily development there. And I am personally looking at our land use codes to see how we can, what modifications we can make to allow smaller units that will incentivize developers to build them. Mm-hmm. So that, for example, if you have a young attorney who's single, you know, who may be working for the county and only making, you know, maybe $50,000-$60,000, but can't afford a $2,000-$2,500 a month mm-hmm. rent, you know, perhaps making some units available that may be around $1,000 or $900 that would be more attainable or more palatable for, you know, some a single professional or a single working class person. You know, we want to, our city should be a place, if we have a school teacher or one of our new police officers or firefighters that want to live in the city, they should be able to live in the city and be able to have access to affordable housing. So in absence of us having a housing authority, we have to look at creative ways to work with private development to be able to incentivize them to be able to build and construct units that have, you know, rent rates that, you know, the average person, and specifically the lower income individuals, can be able to afford as well.
So what is the time by when you think that will be available?
Well, the thing is the developers are on their own schedule in terms of when they will build. It will be a few years off because the property has to get the proper zoning for it. So, and that takes some time, but it gives us time to be able to. I've already brought the idea up to the city administration to look into, to bring back to the commission for us to look. So it's just a matter of time before we put those in place to be able to see what can be done and how it can fit within the city of Miramar.
Okay, thank you for answering that question, because mm-hmm. that's very important. We also want to thank you for taking the time.
Thank you for having me.
Yes, to share your vision, your story on Sak Pase TV show. And what is your last word? What would you like to share with our viewers?
Well, I'd like to share with your viewers, if you have not ever been to Miramar, make sure you come to Miramar. You'll see that it's a beautiful place. And if you're looking a place to relocate or to start a business, we are open for business, and we will welcome you. And Our city is just a phone call or a visit away so that we can help you get into that new home or open that new business in the city of Miramar. And as we like to say here in Miramar, it's right here in Miramar, and so are you.
Yes, that was Mayor Wade Messam of the city of Miramar. Et pour nous tous qui branchés, qui a suivi Sak Pase TV show, le panneau arrivé pour nous aller. Et songez, si nous besoin plus d'informations, nous capables aller sur website Ville de Miramar, c'est miramarfl.gov. Et pour nous-mêmes qui branchés là, nous capables capter nous tous les jours sur Cause Femme. Ou bien, pour plus d'informations, allez sur sakpasemedia.com. Nom c'est Guylene Berry. Jusqu'à ce que nous t'en disions encore, nous avons souhaité que nous restions dans la paix et en même temps, tout, nous cherchions qui est bon pour nous capables de grandir. Investir dans la tête nous pour un demain meilleur. Merci.